This week on Maker Update, hexagons are the bestagons, through the fire and flames, the tiniest train set, and thermoforming your 3D prints. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we scour the internet for all the coolest maker projects to hopefully inspire your own creativity. Happy New Year, I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great. This is a pretty big show, so let's get started with the project of the week. A few months ago, we featured the tiny library that Morley Kert built into this weird space in his apartment. And now he's adding a door to it to make it a secret library. Just the idea of creating a secret door in your own home is enough to make anyone's sense of creativity go wild. And Morley is no exception. And that was one of his first problems to overcome, landing on the right idea. After a consultation with his partner, he quickly realized that his first idea of a Victorian apothecary shelf was just the wrong idea and picked for the wrong reasons. Instead, he built this wall of wooden hexagons. Most of the hexagons would be fixed in place, but there are a few strategically placed ones that would move. They would push in, pop out, rotate, slide, and more. This is also his first deep dive into mechanical engineering, but he was coached through the process by his maker pal, Enginezy. The mechanisms are supported on the backside by 3D printed parts that would sometimes guide CNC cut wooden mechanisms, or sometimes be the mechanical parts themselves. With the door installed, you press in on two of the hexagons to have two others pop out. Rotating the popped out hexagons 60 degrees, release the two locking mechanisms, a deadbolt and a latch. Finally, one additional hexagon on the edge of the door can be slid outwards, which activates an LED strip that is run around the perimeter of the door. With the catches released, the doors can now be slid open, revealing the library behind. The tiny library was cool enough on its own, but the secret door that otherwise looks like an interesting piece of wall art puts it on a whole new level. It's a fantastic project and a great video to document it. More projects. Maker Secret Santa kicked off since our last regular show, which is a gifting ring of incredible maker projects. And Ruth from Kids Invent Stuff picked Maddie from Unnecessary Inventions to make a gift for him, which is a perfect match because a child's imagination is the perfect ground for ridiculous inventions. Like a cannon that fires flaming marshmallows into your hot chocolate. The launcher for the mechanism is this handheld leaf blower, and flames come out from this manifold made from copper piping, along with an igniter for a propane gas grill. But then she goes over the top with the styling, making the barrel look like a candy cane, and the marshmallow feeder mechanism is festooned with presents, lights, and a tiny 3D printed Christmas tree. It looks amazing, and there's just something wild about seeing marshmallows being launched through a wall of fire. And be sure to check out all the other great projects in the Maker Secret Santa ring. Shane from Stuff Made Here wants to be able to stand a chance against his wife in miniature golf. So what's an engineer to do? Well, normally this is where most people would just put in a ton of practice, but instead he's making a mechanical golf club that corrects all of his many golf mistakes mid-swing. The biggest factor here is the angle of the putter head. And in his club, it can pivot against this counterweight, so the inertia of the changing angle doesn't move the whole club. He's using reflective markers on the club shaft, the head, and the ball itself, so it can track all of their positions in real time. What's really incredible is that it can track the position of the club, calculate the angle and reposition the putter, all within the blink of an eye. Incredible. Speaking of incredible, check out this tiny moving model train that fits into an ornament created by Sean Hodgins. Instead of trying to fit a battery, controller, motor, train track, and the tiny town into the ornament, he's turning the ground layer itself, a PCB, into a reverse engineered stepper motor. He's arranging the tracks into a series of coils that can be switched on and off, which moves the train cars around the track. Or at least that was the plan. But he couldn't get the cars to move reliably. So he went back to the drawing board with a motor-driven pulley moving a magnet around a track, He even threw in some addressable LEDs to simulate a day-night cycle. Still a win, still a cool project. And finally, I also really enjoyed this miniature fuse lamp circuit sculpture by Epic DIY Builds. He's installed a short LED filament into the housing of this glass fuse and made a skeleton frame out of a soldered brass rod to enclose the battery and the charging board. There's a tiny micro switch to complete the circuit to turn the lamp on and off. A simple and gorgeous little lamp project. Now for some tips and tools, Uncle Jessy has a great tip on combining 3D printing with thermoforming. This is where you can heat up parts of your print with a heat gun so you can briefly reshape it before it cools down. In this case, he's using this 3D printed hemispherical form to shape the heated plastic. Sort of like vacuum forming, only without the vacuum. He covers everything you need to pull this off. The right pattern, the heating technique, materials. It's a cool technique to know about. From Maker Vibe, we have the Maker Cell, which is a DIY battery pack that you can use to power your projects. It has an array of LEDs to report on the charge status, and it can be charged and programmed via a USB-C port. The cool part is all these docking bases he made for the Maker Cell. Each one has a fixed boost converter that shifts the voltage to 6, 9, and 12 volt outputs. The entire project is open source, so you can get the KiCad files for the PCBs, the bill of materials, 3D printed parts, and everything else you'll need. And on Instructables from Make Studio Jump, we have a clever way to view simple animations, the Praxinoscope. Similar to a zoetrope, the Praxinoscope makes use of an arrangement of mirrors, all at a 45 degree angle. Each frame of the animation is arranged in a circular pattern around the base, and the whole thing is on a lazy Susan. Give it a spin and look at the mirrors at eye level and you can see the animation in motion. It only works on fairly simple animations, but it looks a lot easier to build than a traditional zoetrope. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're checking back on a classic video in their Another Teaching Moment series that's all about how to discharge capacitors safely. Large capacitors can store a huge amount of electricity for a really long time. And since they discharge immediately, they can be incredibly dangerous. But if you have a multimeter and a resistor, you can connect the resistor in series and monitor the voltage on the multimeter until the voltage drains away. The DigiKey website has a helpful calculator to select the right resistor for your capacitor. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects and tips by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.